Hi, I'm Rick Viscomi and I make YouTube fast. In this video, I'm going to share how we test web performance and a few tips for doing the same on your own website. The two test methodologies that we're going to look at are real user monitoring, or RUM, and synthetic testing. Real user monitoring, just as it sounds, gathers performance data from real users as they browse a site. For YouTube, this provides us with the ground truth about how users are experiencing the site. Synthetic testing, on the other hand, is more like a laboratory and is commonly used on demand to analyze a particular use case. Both methodologies collect performance data, but given these distinctions, RUM is especially useful for identifying how fast a page is, and synthetic for identifying how to make it faster. The simplest way to gather and analyze RUM data is with one of the existing analytics products. In fact, Google Analytics can do this for you. At Google, we use a custom solution called Client Side Instrumentation, or CSI. RUM works on three basic levels. First, we instrument our client-side code to provide timing and page state data to the RUM JavaScript library. Then, the library packages up the data and sends it off to the analytics server for later use. And finally, the analytics server provides developers with a dashboard to view the results. Out of the box, most RUM tools measure the general page events published by the Navigation Timing API. But for us, one of the most important performance metrics is how quickly a video plays. The metrics you collect should be customized based on what your application does and what your users are actually waiting for. It's also important to include any contextual information that might have an effect on performance. For example, YouTube users may be exposed to experimental features, and we would need to know what effect that might have had on performance. By keeping track of these variables, we're better able to get insights into the performance of particular demographics. Also, note that the CSI beacon is sent unobtrusively after the critical path of video playback. This helps to ensure that testing does not interfere with the user experience. To analyze the performance data, we turn to the CSI dashboard. Here, we're able to look at the change in performance over time and compare experiments against controls. For example, in this chart, we're comparing the results of an experiment against the baseline control. The experiment times are lower or faster until the last point. We can use the CSI dashboard to slice data by various demographics to understand why this is happening. And when we break the data down by browser, it becomes clear that browser B is responsible for the regression. It's also worth mentioning that because we gather data from so many users, all of whom have different devices on different networks, we typically look at the 50th percentile, or the median value, to give us a representative view of performance data. OK, that's it for RUM. Now let's compare it to synthetic testing. For that, we use WebPagetest, which is a free public tool. And instead of gathering data from real users, we pre-configure synthetic tests to a particular demographic. The tests run in a laboratory-like environment to mitigate the effect of network anomalies, and this is achieved through repetition, so tests that are run many times are considered to be reliable. And finally, when the results are in, we're able to analyze our application-specific metrics along with the test network log. WebPagetest gives you full control over the type of use case for which you want to test. For example, we may be interested in the watch page performance in Chrome over a DSL connection. And being a free public tool, WebPagetests are run on ordinary computers connected to the internet. To test YouTube, however, we need more privileged access to beta versions of the site. So for this reason, we run our own private instances of WebPagetest inside of Google. The results are shown on a waterfall diagram, which is a visualization of the network activity. In this view, we're able to precisely see the activity on the critical path to video playback. And finally, WebPagetest also annotates the waterfall with our application-specific metrics. This gives us the necessary context to better understand what exactly is contributing to slow values. So that's it for our look at synthetic testing. Remember that RUM is only as useful as the metrics you provide. CSI is just one of many tools that does it, but your solution should be just as unobtrusive and lightweight. Synthetic tests should be configured to represent common use cases, like a particular browser, connection, or page demographic. Also, by locating synthetic test machines inside of your own network, you can validate performance on a staging server before launching. To learn more about the Navigation Timing API, check out the Mozilla Developer Network article at this URL. Or for more information on using WebPagetest, check out the link over here, and also look out for my book coming later this year. Thanks for watching.